Hi everybody, welcome to part 2 of the Candlewick Green story. My name is Graham James Brew. In the previous show, we took you back to 1978.
Let's rewind!
Guess what? We are still in 1978. Blackpool, home of entertainment, and also the home of our bass player, Jimmy Miller. So let's pick up from where we left off with Jimmy, outside South Pier, reminiscing.
Candy floss. See, wonderful time. Great time.
Fish and chips.
Fish and chips, yeah. Salt and vinegar. Oh,
fish and chips.
Oh, I can smell it. Who are you? It's Terry Webb. Terry Webb, the lead singer of the band. What are you doing here? He said you're surprised.
I work in Imperial Hotel.
Imperial?
Yes.
Would you and them like to come?
That'd be great.
Oh, thank you. That's great. Yeah. What time?
7 o'clock.
7 o'clock. Looking forward to it.
But Jimmy, this is where it all started. Remember?
This is where it all started. 74. We won opportunity not. The record was getting released. And we had this fabulous summer season here, 74. Packed every night. Really had a good time.
And we came back while I was in the group, another 2 occasions.
That's right. And
you did it three
times. You did it,
yeah.
Three times.
And then you did it without
and
me.
And then we did it without you with the other singer, it was Jeff
yeah,
Lewis.
Yeah.
So we had a great time here, though.
Yeah. And as you remember, some of the stars came to see us here.
That's
Ken Dodd came to see us.
Ken Dodd.
What's it?
Les Dawson.
Les Dawson. Other people.
Yeah.
And we did the ABC Midnight.
That's right, yeah.
With
the Nolans and Larry Grayson.
Yeah. Oh, that's right, yeah.
So it was great. Yeah. We had a great time, yeah.
And I once had to come down here in my car where the tram was on. I was late.
Yeah.
It was backed up with the lighter on. And I just couldn't get to the ears on time if I'd have followed the route.
Yeah.
So I went on here. They're all tooting here and everything. But I got the ear time. At least they catch me. Maybe the man that have done this video. If you spot this video, yeah. No, I can't think. So lovely seeing you.
Yeah, lovely seeing you, Seth.
Let's
yeah.
pick up later.
Absolutely.
And we'll do more for the video.
We'll see you back at the Imperial Hotel tonight after the show.
And we'll get changed.
We will.
Bye, Jimmy. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. It's me again, Jimmy Candlewick Green. Terry's just had to nip off to do a rehearsal for his show, doing a one-man show tonight. But we're here in the middle of Blackpool by Blackpool Tower to show you the comedy carpet, which was opened on the 11th of October 2011 by my dad, Ken Dodd. Yes, it's a wonderful place, all surrounded by the people who've been played here in Blackpool, including in French Sinatra. Absolutely loads of people, over a thousand names on it. It's made up of 10 granite blocks, which are all put together. It was done by an artist called Neil Young. Anyway, that's it. So here we are, sunny Blackpool. Hope you're having a great day wherever you are, and bing! See you soon.
Thanks for that, Jimmy. And now we're gonna rewind. Back to 1975. The lads were asked to sponsor Liverpool group Champagne on Opportunity Knocks. They also did a few impressions from their comedy act, and Huey got a taste of his own medicine. Here's Terry to tell you all about it.
Thank you, Graham. We'll call this scene the slap. Huey wasn't supposed to slap me.
Ladies and gentlemen,
story you are about to see is true. The names have been changed to protect the innocent.
The script was, when he found out I wasn't Tony Holland, who is the real sponsor? And I was going to say, here is a real sponsor, and Jimmy came on dressed up as Huey Green. What do I do now? You can see it on my face if you watch it. 13, 40 million viewers. What do? So I decided to slap him back. I didn't know if he would be offended, humiliated, stop the show, kick us out of the studio. We didn't know what was going to happen. But as luck had it, he took it in the spirit it was meant. And you'll see yourself. Hope you enjoy it.
Well, this way, my producer tells me that the music will introduce you to the national anthem, the musical people's song.
Lenny, it's marvelous. It's really marvelous, Lenny, to have you here tonight, and I understand that you've just made a wonderful new LP and that you'll be playing at Stratford-on-Avon this particular coming Christmas season. Is Di with you tonight?
Yeah.
Di's with you tonight. Well, isn't that nice?
You're not Peterson, Lee. Get off the stage. What is this?
Ladies and gentlemen, I must apologize. This is our producer, Keith Beckett. This is his fault for setting these ridiculous people up. Now, he tells me that the next real sponsor here is a man that we had for many, many weeks on our show, and he is a man that you all know and love, our musical muscle man, Tony Holland. Let's give Tony a big welcome. Tony Holland.
Listen. You're not Tony Holland. I want the sponsor. Where's the sponsor? Are you the sponsor?
No, Huey.
Who's the sponsor?
Huey Green.
Yeah. What do you mean Huey Green's the sponsor?
He's the real Huey Green.
What do you mean the real?
The real.
Don't be cheeky now. Huey Green is the sponsor. I'm Huey Green. No, Huey Green is the sponsor.
Oh,
I'm Huey Green. Well, thank you tremendously, friends. Thank you and welcome. Welcome, my lads, once again to your Opportunity Knocks, the fun show. Because we all love fun on the show. The only show, my lads, my darlings, my turtle doves and seagulls, the only show. The only show where you, the nation, and no panel of judges, you, the nation, I repeat. Now listen, I want to find one thing. Now, just a second.
No,
this guy has done a lot for entertainment, and also this week, ladies and gentlemen, Huey is on the Morecambe and Wise show. Isn't that a little bit of a clap for you? A little bit of a clap. Going to go places because I've got a nose for talent.
You're going to go places at any minute now. Now listen, who are you guys? Will you tell me?
Well, Huey, we are
Candlewick Green.
Candlewick Green. Congratulations. May I say one thing? You look almost as ugly as I. Now, who are you? I understand that you just got a marvelous record. What's the name of it?
It's called The Last Bus Home, Huey.
The Last Bus
Home. Why try and get it, boys.
I want to tell you, it's really good. Really, I don't mind.
Excuse me.
Now, who are you going to introduce on the show?
We're going to introduce a fabulous group from Liverpool called Champagne.
Champagne. All right. You know these kids?
Yeah, great friends of ours.
They're all from Liverpool area.
Yeah.
Right. Boys, congratulations to you. We love watching you and doing all your great work. Good luck with your record. But right now, for Champagne,
Opportunity Knocks. We want to start it.
Well, I hope you all enjoyed that. And staying with the Opportunity Knocks theme, Huey asked us, would we like to perform on two songwriting contests and record two songs? Here is the first one featuring Andy Ball on keyboards. It's called
Do you dig the music?
Performed by Candlewick Green, Opportunity Knocks.
Do you dig the music, baby? Do you dig the melody? Let's sing it through together, ring out through the trees. You're sailing high now, higher than a kite. But when the wind don't blow no more, you'll be a sorry sight. Do you dig the music, baby? Do you dig the melody? Music, baby, you dig the melody. Let's sing it through together, ring out through the trees. You're sailing high now, higher than the moon. But get your feet back on the ground, there'll still be another tune. Do you dig the music, baby? To dig the melody. So you dig the music, baby. You dig the crazy ride. It doesn't help to see things clearer, to have to spend the time. You're sailing high now, up in the morning, it's almost afternoon, it's almost afternoon. You dig the music, baby, you dig the crazy ride. Doesn't help to see things clearer, to help to spend the time. You're sitting high now, it's almost afternoon. Do you dig the music, baby? Do you dig the melody? Do you dig the melody? Do you dig the melody?
Second one has Dudley Jones on keyboards and it's called That Summertime. I'd like to pass you over to Derek, who'll tell you some more about it.
Thanks, Terry. Hello everyone, hope you're all enjoying the show. This song that we're going to do next was a nightmare for poor Dudley. We were asked to mime to the orchestra and Dudley had to mime to the Opportunity Knocks keyboard player, who hadn't got a clue how to play Dudley keyboard. Here's how it should have sounded. And here's how it ended up sounding, going out to 14 million people. Hope you enjoyed.
Ladies and gentlemen, for Martin Jarvis's composition, song number one, That Summertime, sung by Candlewick Green, Opportunity Knocks.
Don't you know that when the sun keeps it shining, you can see a silver lining all through the day? Clouds are gonna break up, it's a kiss and make up time. Don't you know that all the songbirds will be singing and the church bells will be ringing and we will say how we love that summertime. can still remember all the things we planned. Hand in hand we walked along the beach, making love, the stars above seem close enough, but somehow they just seem out of reach. Don't you know that when the sun keeps on shining, you can see a silver lining all through the day. Clouds are gonna break up, it's a kiss and makeup time. Don't you know that all the songbirds will be singing, and the church bells will be ringing, and we will say how we love that summertime. Memories that last forever, the love we share together. Church bells will be ringing, and we will say how we love that summertime.
Make your mind up, time, and don't forget it's your vote which could decide that winning song, which will be announced on Opportunity Knocks on January the 9th. Green, that summertime.
Don't you know that all the songbirds will be singing, and the church bells will be ringing, and we will say how we love that summertime. That summertime.
We're going to take a short break now, so put the kettle on, get the mince pies out, and we'll be back to you right after this.
Chew! Chew!
Lemsip, why suffer when you've got a cold?
If your butter tastes much saltier than Galway Bay, then don't dismay, everything's okay. Spread a little creaminess the Lerpak way. Taste of Lerpak butter is the uppermost. Ask any decent host, it's the cream he'll boast. Spread a little creaminess upon your toast.
Lerpak with creamy taste.
Snow is snowing.
Welcome back to part two of the Candlewick Green story. Here's Alan to tell you more about it.
Thanks, Graham. Hi, everyone. I hope you're all enjoying the show. As was mentioned in part one, 1978 was indeed the busiest year for our group. Having established ourselves on the cabaret scene and had a hit record, Who Do You Think You Are, the TV work just came pouring in. The show that every act wanted to be on in 1978 was Tom O'Connor's London Night Out. And we were thrilled when asked to appear on it, doing comedy and music. So the lads and I thought you might like to join us in a bit of nostalgia and reminisce, looking at the good old days. I hope you like this and it brings back some good memories.
Welcome back to part three. And our next guest, Candlewick Green.
Can't afford the bread now.
Welcome home.
Silly cow. Say to you, it's
like September and I really should be back at school. You laugh at all my jokes. My love, you didn't need to coax.
Something new, nobody else could make me feel the way you do. It's heavenly, it's ecstasy, the way you make me feel when you make love to me. Can't you see, can't you see, this is it,
this is
it. This all I know is the real thing, and I can't explain what I'm feeling. I'm lost for words. Something new, nobody else could make me feel the way you do. It's heavenly, it's ecstasy, the way you make me feel when you make love to me. Can't you see, can't you see, this is it, oh, this I know is the real thing, and I can't explain what I'm feeling. I'm lost for words.
Oh, memories. I have heard a rumour that Jimmy, our bass player, had a lifelong ambition to do the introduction to a top TV show. Well, a gentleman by the name of Dennis Kirkland, producer of the Tommy Cooper Show, made this possible back in 1978. Here's Jimmy.
Yes, it's the Tommy Cooper Show. And here he is, Mr. Tommy Cooper.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, Candlewick Green.
Thank you.
69, late December back in 63. What a very special time for me, as I remember what a night. Oh, what a night. You know I didn't even know her name, and I was never gonna be the same. What a lady, what a night. Oh, I've got a funny feeling when she woke in the room. And my silent calling ended much too soon. Dream she'd be. What a lady, what a night. I felt a rush like a rolling ball of thunder, spinning my head and I'm melting my body under. She woke in the room, and my silent calling ended much too soon. Hypnotizing, mesmerizing me. She was everything I dreamed she'd be. What a lady, what a night.
At last, Mr. Tommy Cooper.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Good on. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, I like that. I think I'll do it again. Thank you, Still Melody. I want you now to meet my brother. Thank you. Thank you, Maestro.
Moonlight becomes you. It goes through your hair. You certainly know the right thing to wear.
Higher!
Moonlight becomes you. It goes with your hair.
I said higher!
With your hair.
Thank you. Thank you very much. And now a little bit of magic.
magic. What is it? It's dark in there.
Just a minute.
You're not supposed to be on now. I'm on now. No. I'm on now. They told me to bet I'm on now. Not you. I think you better get off now. All right, ready? Go ahead. One more time. Up.
Don't take away.
Whoa! Whoa!
Did you know that Derek didn't sing one note on the Tommy Cooper show? That's because he had throat nodules and couldn't sing for 6 weeks. And Derek's wife Sheila won every argument for 6 weeks.
Well, thanks for watching, everyone. We're going to leave you with Backstage Antics 1978 from Candlewick Green. That should be fun, if I can remember it. What we're going to do is, we've not finished with the story yet, so we're going to be resuming the story in January, when we come back in January. So, I hope you enjoy this show, and don't forget to get the mince pies in, glass of sherry, bottle of whiskey for me. See you later, have a good Christmas. Bye bye.
Neville King covered me before.
Yeah.
Neville.
Come on.
So, just a minute, Terry, I'm doing the speaking, aren't I? You get your chance. He told me. Hey, do you mind? He told me. This is dead serious, this. £5 a ticket it is. Now, we've cancelled the do Thursday so that you can be there. Tickets do you want?
I've seen the tickets, it's still got tomorrow's date on. They're not to Friday.
Yeah.
The tickets are the 12th.
Yeah.
Well, so what he's saying, ignore the date.
But what he's saying, Tech, what he's saying in effect is that he's changed the deal for us. It's what we think, lads. You know, I know we're just going on stage and we're all uptight. £25.
£5
But I think that we're going to start saying, well, I'll go and Derek will go, that's a tenner. The other three, we're not bothered, we don't want to go. I think it might be.
I'd say pay the 25.
I think
1,000.
25,000. I think 25,000.
I'll treat you because we're going to, you know, or buy cheaper presents or whatever.
We're not buying presents.
Well, you know.
They're a different kettle of fish. They're paying to go to the
deal. Just learn that in a second.
We're subsidising it.
Probably suits me.
I wouldn't say that.
Bit of junk then.
Pay the lot, you know, £25.
Don't go.
Sorry.
Just drunk my pint.
Hey?
I just drunk my pint.
I didn't have any.
That's fine.
Hey! I don't beep! No.
Yeah. Hey Jimmy!
What?
This camera's out of sync.
Hey Jim, just put your fag. Just put your fag. Look, my mum's gonna be looking here, so wait till my mum gets.
Jimmy!
Suddenly!
Hello, mum.
It's out of sync.
No.
Lips. You have to edit that.
Thanks.
In fact,
Jim. I'll take all the undie bits out.
Get on my lips. Get it in sync. No, you're out of sync. No. You're right. Now.
Alright. Say hello to my mum, Tech.
Hello, Lizzie.
Say hello to me, mum.
She doesn't want to see that. Start again. Hello, Lizzie.
Hello, Mrs. Noonan.
Great, good feeling, mum. Come on. Hello, Mrs. Noonan.
Hello, mum.
Hello, mum.
Hello, mum.
Cards. Postcard!
I've got
the wrong
seat. All out. In fact, we should get about a minute as to what they'll do. A few telegrams from all our fans. That one's from Mick Miller. Here's one from Forrester George. I'll start again. Right. Quick tour of the wall.
Where's Jimmy?
Here's our telegrams. Here's one from Mick Miller. One from Frank from Forrester George. These are our letters that have been sent to us.
Oh.
Objecting to a way of our burlesque, our horrific burlesque of Peters and Lee on the telly. I want each one of us to say hello to the camera.
Okay. What?
Because I want it for posterity.
Yeah.
Okay, Degs.
Okay.
Hello, just going on stage now. It's the 11th of October 1978, summer season, second show on a. What night is it?
Wednesday night.
I'll now introduce you to Terry.
Hello, I'm in the nude, so the camera won't go any lower. But I'm hoping
go on,
to
lower.
Have a good show.
Lower.
I won't go any lower. Okay.
Harold?
Well, I'm just putting my makeup on. I'm just going to go on stage and see if I can.
Are you in the mood, Al?
No, I'm not in the mood, like Teddy, no.
Watery! Watery!
Watery!
No, don't keep to my right, Teddy.
Yes.
Don't go any further left.
Don't go.
Oh, no, you can come in there. Yeah.
Have you got me?
Okay.
Yeah. Oh, sorry, Jim, you've got the lead there.
It's just, you look better. Come back here, yeah, Diggs, you come here.
Right.
You go there and do your bit, you know.
What do you want to say?
Hi, I'm Derek.
Hello, I'm Derek, and I'd like to say it's been fabulous being here, and we'll be glad to get away in a week's time.
Where are you going?
Where are we going?
Back to Liverpool.
Yeah, Alison's.
And he's getting married.
Hello, I'm.
Take the ribbon from your hair. Well, my turn. I hope by the next time I look at this, that we won't be having any more Mellotron problems on the stage, because tonight, the first show, yet again, the first show was terrible. Due to, hang on, got to hold this and do my jacket up at the same time.
Put that there then, I'll show. Yes, I've enjoyed Blackpool, looking forward to coming back in 2 years.
Great, okay, done. It's Harry doing that inevitable style. Around the world.
No.
Killing my hair.
How many are girls?
Killing my hair. Yes, well, I'm about ready to go on now, so I'll hand you over.
Before we go on stage, I'm going to regroup afterwards and see how we look later. Yeah. We're just going on stage now.
Bye-bye.
I'm going to hear you.
Bye-bye.
Teddy's gone down there.
Bye-bye.
Okay, bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Hello, I'm not here now. I'm there.
Oh, no.
I'd like to wish a happy Christmas and a happy new year to all the Facebook members of the Candlewick Green Comedy Group. So happy Christmas, everyone, and happy Christmas to all of you. I hope to see a lot of you on February the 9th at my final show. I'll be performing at the Connie Club in Derby Lane, Old Swan, Liverpool, February the 9th. So I hope to see a lot of you. Once again, Merry Christmas, Happy New Year to everyone.
Then we can build a snowman and pretend that he is Parson Brown. We'll say, I am
Hi everybody, just to wish all our members and friends a really Merry Christmas and a really great New Year. So bye for now. Bye, Happy Christmas. Happy Christmas. Bye.
I'd like to wish everyone a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. God bless.
I'd just like to wish you all a very, 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 very prosperous New Year and good health. And thank you for being part of our lives. We hope we're bringing a little bit of cheer to some of you. I'm not going to keep this going, but I'd like to also thank Graham, James, Bruce. I always get the mix of them for the end. For doing a fabulous job on the racing on the last two videos that we've done. Thanks very much, James. Hope you have a great time. Graham, you will get mixed up. Thanks very much, Graham. So all I've left to say is Merry Christmas to everyone. Merry Christmas. And a Happy New Year.
Everybody.